Cedar Falls is a great city to live in with abundant activities for all ages. I'm Veronica Harper and you're watching Cedar Falls Connect. Today we'll be talking with the YMCA, and to better understand the organization and what it has to offer, we'll talk with Kirk Alexander, who is the CEO of the Waterloo YMCA, as well as Ali Maz, who is the wellness director. In the first half of the show, we'll be discussing the history of the YMCA and its mission and what it's brought to the Cedar Falls Waterloo area. And in the second half of the show, we'll be speaking with wellness director Ali to go over some fun activities that will be open to the public in the upcoming months.
YMCA in Waterloo started out in 1868. Then we actually had a branch here in Cedar Falls all through the, I believe, 40s, 50s, and 60s. And it was a real strong YMCA located right on Main Street in Cedar Falls.
So it is located in just over the border of Cedar Falls into,
yep.
into Waterloo. Do you feel that it's more of a Waterloo community or for the Waterloo community or for both?
We have members in Waterloo. We have members in Cedar Falls. We have them in Denver. We have them in Dyke. I mean, we literally are throughout the entire Cedar Valley. It really can be a common place regardless of what your zip code is.
And how many members do you have?
We currently have right around 4,000 members. And our membership, if you look at where they reside, is almost split pretty equal to the number of citizens that live in Cedar Falls as well as the citizens that live in Waterloo area.
On that note, we will be right back after a quick break. And when we come back, we'll be talking about all the fun activities that the Y has to offer and how you can get involved. Stay with us. Welcome back to Cedar Falls Connect. I'm Veronica Harper, and we are speaking today with Kirk Alexander, CEO of the Waterloo YMCA, along with wellness director Ali.
And just quite a variety of different activities for the whole family. We also have an extensive different types of dance, from ballroom dancing to youth dancing, even kind of a Latin dance, which is our Zumba class. So quite a variety of group exercise classes. We also offer personal training for individuals, as well as we have some specific programs to work on total wellness for the entire, for each individual.
Great, that's a handful.
Yeah.
So you basically cover it all. And also you have some fun seasonal events.
Yeah.
You have done in the past a free Halloween event. You've done a Thanksgiving holiday basket event.
It's an annual thing that we do during the week right before Halloween. This is kind of either an alternative or something in addition to trick-or-treating. There's a variety of members, and many of our members receive scholarship assistance in their membership for those that maybe can't afford it. And so we reached out to those members and that receive that assistance.
In the Thanksgiving holiday basket, how many families were you able to help out?
We did reach the all 50 that had requested
them.
We didn't, you know, it was kind of a stretch at the end, but we were able to make them all work. We really just didn't want to turn anybody away.
And then as far as the hams, you were able to reach some more families.
Yep, we did another
fun one that's also free to the public. It's called Crop at the YMCA.
Yep.
And I know we have a lot of scrapbooking fanatics here in town. Talk to us about that.
Yep, that was something we've been doing actually a little over a year. We do that on the second Friday of every month from 6 until midnight.
And that's an ongoing?
Yep.
Okay,
yep.
All year
that's
round.
That's an ongoing activity.
What kind of special demos have you had in
Our most recent was a paper bag album, how to make a scrapbook out of a simple paper bag.
That's a successful activity,
yeah.
I take it. Easter egg hunt. And this is kind of unique. It's actually done in your pool.
Yeah.
Pool, yeah.
Yep. This was something we started last year and went over really, really well. Kids showed up in their swimsuits. And as I said, even our swim team kids, you know, swam to the bottom of the pool to collect as many as they could, too. So
it's in the morning, you have.
From 9
what age?
Yep, in the morning we did a 9 until 11.
And do people have to pre-register for
nope,
that?
No, this is another event that they can just show up and participate in. Like I said, they can just jump in the pool. After all the eggs are found, then we kind of let it be a free swim time for all the kids that are there.
Talking about swimming, you have a splash week that you guys do every year, is it?
Yep.
Yeah, and in this, again, it's open to the public, and you give free swim lessons for the entire week.
For the entire week, we do have swim lessons ages all the way down to 3 years old, all the way up to about 12 years of age.
Students, do you have per group, or kind of break that down?
The classes are smaller for the younger kids,
okay.
But as they get older, we really like to keep it to that 1 to 6 1 to 8 on the really old age group, but for the smaller kids, we'll keep it, you know, anywhere between 1 to 4. Lots of times we'll have some of our swim team kids assist as aids, swim aids, and so they'll actually be in the water as an aid to assist the actual swim instructor. So we have a couple hands on deck, so to speak, just to kind of provide some assistance.
Include your child care and your daycare programs. And in this, you have a child development center, is that right?
It's a child development center, and that's designed for children as young as 18 months all the way through school age. And one thing that really probably separates our child development center from anyone else in the area is we put such a huge value on education, try to kind of cross program and engage the kids as much as we possibly can in everything going on in our building.
And you have some volunteer opportunities as well.
We offer youth sports, swim lessons, we have the Child Development Center, we have day camp coming up this summer that I'm sure if I let Allie have the floor with that one, she'll go for days talking about day camp.
And as far as, you guys really just do include everybody from the youngsters to the elderly, and I want to go back to Allie if I could. Talk to us a little bit about the day camp.
This is an opportunity for kids to really develop in a huge way, not like they do necessarily in school. School can be a really limiting place for some kids, and our day camp program is really going to give them the opportunity to find things that they enjoy, lots of different games.
Now, I want to make sure that we cover everything. Another important activity that you have, a program rather, that you have is called Together We Play.
Partnered with an agency out of San Diego that really kind of helped us elevate the program to where Together We Play is designed for youth that have special needs to get them interacted and engaged with regular kids and in youth sports, in Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, the whole nine yards. And we're really trying to work with other agencies in the community to kind of make sure that they can fully engage those kids, regardless of what they may perceive as their limitations, realizing that kids just want to be involved.
Some people might think of the YMCA as a workout or rec center. It's so much more than that. It's not only a resource and training center, but it's a nonprofit organization established to serve the local community. It has 4,000 members and connects diverse populations. When you join, you're not only a member, but you're a part of the community. Thanks again for being with us. I'm your host, Veronica Harper, and we hope you'll join us next time right here on Cedar Falls Connect.